Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Adding Negative Numbers. In this video, you will learn how to add negative numbers using a number line. Ready to zoom around on number line? Let's go! By now, adding numbers may seem like old news, but there are actually different kinds of numbers to add. Different kinds? Well, yes. Perhaps you already know different kinds like whole numbers, fractions, and decimals. Here, we'll be talking about a specific type of whole number, an integer. A positive integer is any whole number greater than zero. A negative number is any number less than zero. Remember, whole numbers or integers are numbers without fractions or decimals. By the way, zero is neutral and is neither positive nor negative. Most of the time, you see and write positive numbers without the plus or positive sign. When you work with negative numbers, however, you may see them written either with or without the plus or positive sign to the left of the integer. So, just like this example, 18 with a plus sign is exactly the same as 18 without a plus sign. You can also use parentheses around the integer to show its value as being positive. All three ways show exactly the same value, positive 18. When we write negative numbers, we must always allow and use a negative sign to the left of the number like this. Both of these show negative 3. When writing negative numbers in math sentences like addition equations, we also use parentheses to make sure we don't confuse a negative number with subtraction. Here, let me show you a number line. On our number line, you can see positive integers are greater than zero, are to the right of zero, and increase to the right. Negative integers are less than zero and are to the left of zero. They decrease to the left. Yes, I know, it looks odd, but trust me, as you move to the left, the numbers are worth less, even though the numbers are going up. Look at this number line. Okay, it shows how integers moving to the right increase or go up in value, and how integers moving to the left decrease or go down in value. Adding moves the number up or to the right, and subtraction moves the number down or to the left. This is the same, no matter which side of the zero you are. We can use this knowledge to help us add negative numbers. Let's get started with this math sentence. Negative 5 plus 4. Use a number line to get started. Always start at zero. You can see the negative 5 is a negative integer. This tells us to move to the left on the number line, so we move 5 spaces to the left of 0. Then we must add 4, as the number sentence tells us. Adding means moving to the right on the number line. So now, from the negative 5, move right 4 spaces. Where did you end up? That's right, negative 1. Great job! Here, let's do another one. 16 plus negative 7. The first integer is 16, which means positive 16. Remember, there is no sign in front of the number. It shows a positive integer. Start at 0 and move in the positive direction or right 16 spaces. Then, the number sentence tells us to add a value of negative 7. Negative numbers move to the left. So, from our spot on 16, move 7 spaces to the left. You should land on the 9. Which 9? It is the positive 9 because we've landed to the right of the 0. Okay, so this is where it can get tricky. What if you have 2 negative numbers to add? No worries, it's the same steps as the previous 2 problems. You can do this. Okay, let's try negative 3 plus negative 4. Just start on the 0 as always. Go 3 steps to the left for the negative 3, then keep going left 4 spaces because you have a negative 4. We end up landing on negative 7. Let's review this by comparing a number line to a math map. Adding negative numbers is like following three directions on a map. Start at 0. For the first number, move left or right depending upon whether you have a positive or negative number, and stay there. And last, for the second number, move left or right depending on whether that second number is positive or negative. Whether you land on the map or number line, you've landed on your answer. Ready to try a couple of your own? Pause the video and try problem A and problem B. Problem A, 5 plus negative 5. Problem B, negative 9 plus 4. I'll share the answers when you get back. Here are the answers. Problem A's answer is 5 plus negative 5 equals 0, and problem B's answer is negative 9 plus 4 equals negative 5. How did you do? You can always go back and review the steps if you need more help. Well, now that you've taken a trip on the math number line and learned how to add negative integers, you're ready to tackle subtracting negative integers in our video, Subtracting Negative Numbers. It's always a great idea to keep practicing all your math skills using our fun online games and quizzes. Until next time, always be positively clever.